Masechet Machshirin, Perek Dalid, Mishnah Vav. Sixth Mishnah in the fourth chapter of Masechet Machshirin. Kupa, if I have a basket, she milei'a turmosin. What are turmosin? So we look in the Jastro. Turmosin is a kind of legume. A lupine. Everybody knows what a lupine is. No, you know, this is a lupine that brought in with the desert. Do we have a Jastro bonus? Do we have, no, we don't really have it. It was very, so, ah, here we go. Machshirin, yes, we do. Turmosin, okay. Why is that important? Why are lupines important? So if you look it up, okay, this produces, these are the lupin beans. The lupin beans are yellow legume seeds. They're traditionally eaten as a pickled snack food. Okay, the most, in the Mediterranean area was the most ancient evidence of lupins from ancient Egypt. Okay, this is what's most interesting. The bitter variety of the beans are high in alkaloids and extremely bitter unless rinsed methodically. So part of the process of getting these, and by the way, they were poisonous to some degree unless you prepare them right. They were bitter and inedible. But part of the process of preparing these beans from the lupin plant, and if you look up the lupin plant, right, you'll see, let me see if I can find it. Yeah, this is a lupin plant. You'll see that, and you can find these in Israel, you can see them. Part of the process is soaking it methodically. Soaking it methodically is a problem for us because if you soak it methodically, you're making it wet, you're machshir lekabel tuma. So it's really, you have a problem. The preparation of the food requires it be soaked. What then do you do? So the Mishnah sort of tells us what they did. Kupashi milea tumasin, you have a basket full of these lupine beans. Unitanu l'toch mikvah. So the way you solve this problem is if you put it in a mikvah. Why? We'll see in a second. Therefore, moshit yado, a person who is an avatuma, can stick out his hand, vinotel tumasin mutocha, and take lupin beans from in the basket as long as he doesn't remove them, vehem tahorim. They're still tahor. Says the Bartudura, Afa Pisha Pashat Adam Tamed Yadov and Atal, the person stuck his hand into the basket and took things out of the basket. Since it's in the water, the fishaloch shabim shabim mikvah. While they're in the mikvah, this is what he means. While it's in the mikvah, they're not machshir lohuch shuru. Why? Dichtiyav it says bechol kli tamei. They have to be in a kli bechol kli yitma. They're in a kli that's mitamei. Ma kli miyuchad shu talush umachshir. Right, this kli is miyuchad. It's a kli that's talush. It's not connected to the ground, right? But therefore, it's machshir lekabel tuma. Af kol shu talush umachshir. So too, anything that's talush separated, machshir. That could be machshir. Afuke mayim. That comes to exclude water. Shebe borot sichin umearot that are in wells and caves and crevices. Meaning natural water sources. She'enam talushi mina karka that are not separate from the ground. She'enam machshirim kozman shelo nidlashu. They're not machshir kabotum as long as the water hasn't been separated from its source. So like what I love about this, when you find out what was the problem, you have this lupin plant and they had to soak it. But how do I soak it so that it's not machshir, that people can handle it still, they don't have to worry about its production. You just put it in the mikvah. That's the solution. Okay, they're still tahor. But he'ela min amayim, so when you take it out of the water, then you have a problem. So therefore, if it's taken out by the av hatuma, hanogim bakupas, you have this whole basket full. So then the stuff that touches the basket, the lupins that are on the layer touching the basket, tmeim, those are tamei rishon. I mean, if an av hatuma took out the basket, okay, then now the water is separated. So now they're muchshir lekabel tuma. Those that touch the lupins, the beans that are touching the basket are tamei. Why? When an Adam tamei, if an avatuma touches the basket, he makes the basket of rishon. And the lupin beans that are touching, they're sheni. Ushakol turmasim, and the rest, like you have a whole layer on the bottom, layer of the basket, and the rest in the middle are tohorim. Why? That are not touching the basket. The ain sheni osa shlishi b'chulin. Just for chulin, and since it's chulin, they're not. There's no such thing as shlishi. They're a sheni. Tsunon shebe me'ara. Let's say I have a radish that's in the cave. Nida midachato v'hutara. Same kind of thing. Okay. Deloch shel kabel tuma ma'im shibchubai mishebe me'ara. Same thing. If I need to wash something. I need to make it. You people, I guess, would leave their produce that has to be, I don't know, kept or washed in the mikvah, and it's tahor. Ha'elta kol shumin amayim tameh. So I guess the women would bring the food to the mikvah and wash it and prepare it. And then they would say to the kid or whoever, take it out of the water, because now it's mukshar lekabel tuma. We'll stop here. Dedicate our learning to the memory of my father, Rav Simcha ben Yitzchak Kalman. Make it a great day.